This is Heat Radio. I'm James Barr. I've got Taylor Lautner here. Hi, how are you?
I'm doing good.
Well, you're back now, and BAFTA-nominated comedy Cuckoo is back as well.
Yeah.
And it's incredible. If you've not seen it, it's kind of like a Gavin and Stacey vibe. I love it. I've seen the new episode, obviously, which just dropped on iPlayer. Like, explain sort of in your head what the show's about.
Oh my goodness. This is like, this is the hardest show to sum up because it is the craziest show. There is so much going on. I play Dale. I am the long-lost son of Cuckoo, played by Andy Samberg.
Yep.
And
I'm glad you're explaining it.
Right?
It is so, like, complex, but it's so hilarious.
I know. So I show up in season two looking for my father.
Who died.
Your
father, like, married Rachel.
Correct.
So then you show up.
I show up. I call her mom, but we're actually closer in age than her and Cuckoo. So we have some sexual chemistry as well.
Well, actually, don't you actually have more than just chemistry, right?
Yes. Yes.
Which is odd because she's your mom.
It is.
Well, she's your stepmom.
It's insane. Yes, she's my stepmom. If that's what you'd call it.
It's horrible because it's like me imagining my stepmom. And I just can't go there.
That's a good thing.
Yeah.
In season two, we do end up getting together. But by the end of it, Dale realizes, you know, everything just doesn't seem to make sense. And he leaves, disappears. And the Thompson family don't think they're ever going to see him again.
Because the first scene is you in China.
Yeah.
And there's like, or Hong Kong.
Yeah.
And there's like, I mean, there's like these men coming at you. They want to kill you.
Right.
You turn into Kung Fu Panda.
Right.
And you basically have them. That must have been a really fun scene to shoot.
It was, yeah. I started doing martial arts when I was 6 years old.
That's cool. Yeah. So you did the whole thing?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
That's all you?
Yeah.
No, I don't believe you. Really?
Yeah.
There's no stuntman in there. That's 100% you.
That's 100% me.
Wow.
Yeah. When
that
we had
awesome.
To choreograph the whole thing in one day and then film the whole thing in one day, it was madness.
We should talk about Twilight as well.
Okay.
Because obviously, like, that was insane. And talk about bod goals. Like, I only just found out in an interview with you recently that you that originally they weren't going to put you in the second film. They were going to get someone else to do that.
Right. Yeah. My character, Jacob Black, goes through such a huge transformation, a physical transformation between the first book and the second. In their minds, they always planned to cast a 16-year-old at the time, which I was, to play the first Jacob, and then cast somebody like 10 years later, or 10 years older, to, you know, play the second Jacob.
But what was your routine like?
There was a year between the filming of the first movie and the second, it was just 5-6 days a week working out nonstop.
So obviously in the books, like, it ends where you've, like, Jacob's imprinted on Renesmee.
Yeah.
And that's it. Like,
yeah.
We don't know what happens next.
Right.
So, I mean, what's your theory on that? Because obviously there's quite a lot of different theories online.
Yeah.
Do you think they become friends?
No. I think, so she, I'm trying to remember this exactly. She ages at an accelerated rate. So I think, like, in the matter of, like, a few years or something, she'll be caught up to me. So yeah, it is weird to think about for those first few years while she's an infant.
Right. What the hell happens?
Yeah.
Do you think there'll ever be a new book? And if there was, would you be interested in getting involved with it?
I have no idea if there'll be a new book. And I mean, I certainly would be, you know, open to the idea. But at this point, I think we've all aged a little too much.
I agree. You keep everything very private. How do you do that? Because obviously you're not on social media and stuff.
I don't know. I've always been sort of a private person. And I think when you're so young and everything's like, you know, it hits you over the head so quickly, and your privacy is kind of taken from you. You sort of like go like this a little bit, but you know, it's definitely loosened up over the past few years, and I'm considering maybe like getting on Instagram or something like that.
Do not do it.
Do not do it.
I don't know. Like, do you not meet people that are on it and think they're a bit like obsessed with likes and stuff?
Yeah. Yeah, totally. I would definitely need to control myself, but it's, you know, I do enjoy connecting with the fans some way, you know, other than just actually meeting them in person, which is the best. But so I'm open to the idea.
Okay, so we could see you on Instagram soon.
Possibly.
Oh my God, very exciting. All How right. soon? This year?
I don't know. Haven't even thought about that.
Taylor Lautner, it's been great to have you on Heat.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.
Woo!